Today, I'm asking you to put your trust in Christ. I'm going to ask you to pray this prayer, sentence by sentence, after me. Dear Heavenly Father, I know that I'm a sinner, and I ask for your forgiveness. I believe you've died for my sins and rose from the dead. I turn from my sins. I repent of my sins. I invite you to come into my heart and life. I want to trust and follow you as my Lord and Savior. In Jesus' name, amen.
Remember just a while back, a man in my own town in Illinois who was a known drug addict, drug dealer, fornicator, absolutely everything, and he is there. He passes away. And the pastor of one of the largest Baptist churches in the area, standing there, funeral. That place is loaded with every person that's hardly ever been in church. Drug addicts and everything you can imagine are all there in church to honor their dead friend. And that pastor gets up and he says, I praise God. I know this young man. He sowed a lot of wild oats. But when he was 9 years old, I was there when he prayed to receive Jesus Christ as his Savior. And he's in heaven today. And all those lost sinners went straight out into the streets, justified in their sin because of conservative evangelical Baptist preaching. That's typical in almost every church in this country. It's true. It's true. And it's.
What about those like the Jews, the Muslims, who don't believe as
you
believe?
That's in God's hands. I can't be the judge.
You don't judge them?
No. No,
how do you feel when
going to hell? And
how do you feel when you see a lot of these strong Christian leaders go on television and say, "You are condemned. You will live in hell if you do not accept Jesus Christ." And they are forceful and judgmental.
Well, they have a right to say that, and they are true to a certain extent. But I don't. That's not my calling. My calling is to preach the love of God and the forgiveness of God.
Tell me, what do you think is the future of Christianity?
I think everybody that loves Christ or knows Christ, whether they're conscious of it or not, they're members of the body of Christ. And that's what God is doing today. He's calling people out of the world for his name, whether they come from the Muslim world or the Buddhist world or the Christian world or the non-believing world. They are members of the body of Christ because they've been called by God. They may not even know the name of Jesus, but they know in their heart that they need something that they don't have, and they turn to the only light that they have, and I think that they are saved and they're going to be with us in heaven.
This is fantastic. I'm so thrilled to hear you say that. There's a wideness in God's mercy.
There is.
There was an interview that was held between Robert Shuler and Dr. Billy Graham on the Hour of Power. I have the transcript of that conversation. The conversation went like this. Dr. Shuler said, "Tell me, what is the future of Christianity?" Dr. Graham said, "I think there's the body of Christ, which comes from all the Christian groups around the world, or outside the Christian groups. I think everybody that loves Christ or knows Christ, whether they're conscious of it or not, they're members of the body of Christ, and I don't think that we're going to see a great sweeping revival that will turn the whole world to Christ at any time." In other words, what he's saying is there are people in the body of Christ who never heard of Christ, so we don't need to expect that they're all going to come to Christ. They're going to come another way. Further, he says, God's purpose for this age is to call out a people for his name, and that's what God is doing today. He's calling people out of the world for his name, whether they come from the Muslim world or the Buddhist world or the Christian world or the non-believing world. They are members of the body of Christ because they've been called by God. They may not even know the name of Jesus, but they know in their hearts that they need something that they don't have. And they turn to the only light they have, and I think they're saved, and they're going to be with us in heaven. Dr. Shuler responded, What I hear you saying is that it's possible for Jesus Christ to come into a human heart and soul and life, even if they've been born in darkness and have never heard and never had exposure to the Bible. Is that a correct interpretation of what you're saying? Dr. Graham, yes it is, because I believe that. I've met people in various parts of the world in tribal situations. They've never seen a Bible or heard about a Bible, have never heard of Jesus, but they've believed in their hearts that there is a God, and they've tried to live a life that was quite apart from the surrounding community in which they live. Dr. Schuller, this is fantastic. I'm so thrilled to hear you say that. There is a wideness in God's mercy. Dr. Graham, there is. There certainly is. This has certainly leaped from Aristotle to the Catholic Church into evangelical Protestantism. Now we have a kind of Protestant viewpoint that says Muslims and Hindus and whoever are going to be in the body of Christ, in the kingdom, in heaven, with salvation, whether they ever get a Bible or whether they ever hear the gospel or whether they ever know about Jesus Christ. The Billy Graham organization affirmed that this position is the same as the one articulated in an article in Decision magazine, which Billy wrote in 1960, so this is not something new.